Protective hairstyles play a major role in growing your natural hair, and if done incorrectly, can literally destroy your hair. No one ever makes me feel the way. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Toriiseju and I do beauty, lifestyle and natural hair videos. So please don't forget to like, subscribe and leave a comment, and yeah, let's get straight into this video. So in this video, I'm going to be talking about three protective hairstyles that you should avoid and that can literally destroy your hair if done incorrectly. I'm going to talk about what is really a good protective hairstyle. A good protective hairstyle is basically a protective hairstyle that works for your particular hair strands, that is tension free, that is low manipulation. So what do I mean by all this? If you're putting in a protective hairstyle, what does it cause? Is it tension free in the sense that when you're putting it in, does it cause you pain? Is it tight? Is it, are you over manipulating your hair for that particular hairstyle? Or if this particular hairstyle works well for your type of hair strands, that means you have fine hair strands, you have thick hair strands. If you have fine hair strands, that means you can't do protective hairstyle that will weigh down on your hair strands because they can easily snap and break. And if you have thick hair strands, you do not put protective hairstyles that have so much weight because you can do a lot more than having fine hair strands. That doesn't mean you should overdo it. Also, a good protective hairstyle is a hairstyle that your ends are tucked in. If your ends are not tucked in a protective hairstyle, it's really not a protective hairstyle, because in the sense, it's supposed to protect your whole hair. So if your whole hair is not protected, it's not a protective hairstyle. I'm going to be sharing with you three protective hairstyles that are trending now and can cause your hair more damage if done incorrectly or if taken down incorrectly. So the first one I'm going to talk about is leave out. Leave out is a hairstyle that is trending now. People are doing this particular hairstyle, and I'm not saying don't make this particular hairstyle, like if you love it, go ahead and do it, but I'm just sharing with you, like, there are a lot of disadvantages to this hairstyle, and it shouldn't be called a protective hairstyle because trust me, it's a leave out. Like the front part of your hair, the back part of your hair, whatever part you're leaving out is literally out. And in a good sense, protective hairstyles is when your ends are tucked in and when your overall hair are tucked in, and pretty much your hair is not tucked in. And also the bad part of this protective hairstyle is that you use heat to your hair. You're constantly always adding heat to that particular part of your hair. Trust me, if you want to know if this protective hairstyle is so bad, take a picture on the first day you do that protective hairstyle and take a picture when you're taking it down. Trust me, you see that your ends are thinning out and your hair doesn't look the same way it normally would. You're doing leave outs to your hair. The first red flag is that doing your leaving out particular, you're leaving out your hair isn't tucked in. That means it's not a good protective hairstyle. And red flag number two is that you're always going to be putting heat to your hair. That's another red flag you should look out for. And the third red flag is using thread. So a lot of people don't know this, but when you're doing sew-ins, when you're doing leave-outs, you're literally using thread to sew in that weave to your hair. And threads can cause friction over time. Your hair can tangle with the thread, and when you're taking them down, if you're not careful enough, trust me, you're not going to be that careful. You just want them down, you're going to cut off your hair. So that's why I don't see this as a protective hairstyle. And I also see people cut their hair. I know some people don't really care, like hair is hair, to grow back. Some people don't have attachments to their hair, but I see people cutting their hair for that protective hairstyle. Like now, if they want a bulb, their other ends of their hair are literally put in cornrows and tucked in, but they leave out, they cut it for that particular length, or they do layers to their hair, which they look cute, they are good. And leave out are so, they are so trendy now. Even me myself, I wanted to do leave out because I found this afro leave outs that can blend well to your hair. I'm going to do that, but that doesn't, like, I don't see it as a red flag because number one, I'm wearing it as a wig, I'm not sewing in the weave to my hair. And number two, it's just like me doing a twist out, because I'm going to twist out my the hair that is outside for that particular hairstyle? Will I leave that for a long term? Is it going to be a long term hairstyle? No, it's not going to be long term. It's probably for a week. I'll leave it at most a week or 2 weeks if I want to give it a stretch. But trust me, that is not my protective hairstyle. It's just my hair being out and resting before putting it in a protective hairstyle, and I'm not adding heat to it. So that's something that you should always look out for. If your protective hairstyle is you're adding heat, it's not, your ends are not tucked in, that means it's not a good protective hairstyle. And trust me, leave outs are not a good protective hairstyle. It looks cute, but it's not a good protective hairstyle. And trending hairstyle I'm going to talk about is micro twist. It was trending a lot, like it's still trending now, but it was doing a lot more like late last year, late 2023. It was really, really everywhere. Everybody was getting micro twists. Everybody was doing micro twists. It looks cute, but trust me, it might seem like a good protective hairstyle because all your hair is tucked in, but really it's not a good protective hairstyle. The first red flag is how tiny it is. Like, it's literally micro twist. And I know most people say that it's super lightweight, it's not heavy. If you use passion twist, it's a lot more lighter than using kinky. But using kinky twist, but trust me, your hair shouldn't be that tiny, because number one, it's prone to tangles. Like, your hair is prone to matting up and getting tangled, because most people that do micro twist keep it for a month, keep it for 2 months, keep it for 3 months, and during that time your hair is going to get matted up, it's going to get tangled, and if your hair is in smaller sections, it's going to fall off, or either you mistakenly pull it out or your hair is going to break. So you're going to see excessive breakage when doing tinier hair. Second thing is that most people that install this hair, like your hairdresser, your hairstylist, are not careful enough to not install it. They install it so tight that over time your hair is going to literally shed off. So shedding is the normal cycle of your hair, but if your hair is so tight, the shedding, you can experience excessive hair shedding. And if your hair is shedding in that particular section, if the shedding is so much, that means you have less hair carrying that particular extension, and that means your hair can fall off. So that's another red flag. Red flag is tension, because your crown area, that is your edges, are the places that are prone to more hair loss and more breakage. And if you're putting your hair in tiny sections, they're going to weigh down, the weight of that extension is going to weigh down your hair strands, and your hair is going to break off. Like, you lose your edges will be gone. And why do that to your hair? That's not a good protective hairstyle. That put micro twist on, they keep it for longer periods of time because they think, oh, it's a protective hairstyle, but it's really not a good protective hairstyle, and you should try and avoid it. But if you want to do twist, make it sure that they're a little bit more bigger and you don't wear it so long term, because they can end up getting matted up or tangled. And if you're not really careful in taking down that particular hair, you're going to experience a lot of hair loss. That means your hair is going to remain stagnant, or worse, your hair is going to get shorter. So that is not a good protective hairstyle. Last hairstyle I'm going to talk about is the rubber band method. Whichever way you're using your rubber bands, whichever hairstyle you're doing, because I know there are a lot of people that use rubber bands to make their hair themselves, or to make it easier to put it in sections, to do braids. I see that a lot on TikTok, but rubber bands are not good for your hair. They cause a lot of tension on your hair and they grip your hair strands, which can cause it to snap, to break, and it dries out your hair faster. Try and get them, learn to make your hair without adding rubber bands. If you need to practice on it, do practice on it, but using rubber bands on your hair and keeping it long term for the stretch of that protective hairstyle, when you're taking them down, you see that your rubber band has a lot more, like you can see your hair stuck to that rubber band because it has gripped your hair. Your hair has broken off and it tangles on the rubber band and can cause your hair, especially when you're taking them down, like rubber band down, if you're trying to cut it, you can mistakenly cut your hair, or if you're trying to loosen them up, you can easily still grab on other hair strands and break them off. So yeah, those are like my three protective hairstyles that avoid, because they're trending now. People want to hop on it and do that hairstyle. There are ways to do like your own twist on it, to like I mentioned, if you want to do leave out, you can do wigs instead of doing sew-ins, or if you want to do a leave out, try and get a hair texture that is similar to your natural hair that you don't need to add a lot of heat or heat at all to your hair. There are a lot of alternatives to these hairstyles, and yeah, those are like my three protective hairstyles that you should avoid or stop making, especially if you're looking to grow your hair. So yeah, this is the end of this video. I have another video on protective hairstyles that you can try that have worked for me. I'll link it in the description box so you can check out. And yeah, that's the end of this video. And if you have any questions, or if you have any protective hairstyles that you probably did and they didn't work for you, you can leave it in the comment section so that other people can know what hairstyles to avoid. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.